Recently, I made the video on Jupiter's transit into Sagittarius, in which I said that when you were young, then do you remember running a race? You're running, and many people like the analogy. But today in this video, I want you to go back to your past again and think, did you win a race? Because everybody runs the race, but only one or two wins it. So, was there a time when you won a particular race in your past, and what happened after winning the race? You thought that I've conquered the world, or maybe you would have thought that I don't have to do anything else now, and for eternity I will be the winner, I will always win, right? This is what you thought. And then what happens after some time of winning the race? Life gets back to normal. And then there is a new race. There's a new race which you run equally in an enthusiastic manner, the way you ran for the previous race. And again you feel that just the thing which I need to do to be happy in this world is to run this race. And once I finish this, or rather saying finishing, I would say, once I win the first prize, it is all done, it is all mine. So basically the point is, the cycle keeps repeating again and again and again. You win a race, you think it is all yours, and then the new race begins. So now what is happening is, Jupiter on 29th March, around that time, had entered the sign of Sagittarius, and it is still in Sagittarius. And on 10th April 2019, it is going stationary. Stationary means, from the perspective of the Earth, it is not moving. And after 10th, it is going retrograde. And around the third week of April, I guess, yes, 22nd April, it is entering the sign of Scorpio again, in Jyeshtha Nakshatra again, okay. And till 8th May, it is in Gandanta, which is still 29 degrees of Scorpio. And then it is continuing its retrogression till 10th of August, around that time, when it is stationing. And then finally, again, it's going direct, and finally, it will again enter the Gandanta zone in end of October this year. And then it will finally move into Sagittarius by November 5th, and then a few days it will again be in the Gandanta zone for first degree of Sagittarius. So this is the brief timeline of this transit. So why I'm giving these dates is not just because it's like a formality, you know, just give the dates and you just need to know the dates. No, that's not the main point. What is going to happen is, you would have realized that Jupiter entered Gandanta from 16th, 17th, around that time of March this year. I made that video also. From 16th March to 8th May, it will hover around in the Gandanta zone. So when a planet enters the Gandanta zone, things which you were trying to do from long time, that finally happened. So regarding the houses which Jupiter rules in your chart, the sign number 9 and the sign number 12, whichever house it falls, you would have felt that around the time of December last year, I would say, from that time, or rather you could say November, there is something which you have been trying so hard, but it has not been achieved. But now finally, you saw that either you have achieved it after 16 March, or you have given it up, or you have changed the course, but something, the climax has happened. But now what is happening is, Jupiter has stationed now, it is stationary. So that means today is 9th, and maybe when you see the video it will be 10th somewhere. These 2 days, 9th, 10th and 11th, Jupiter is stationing, and it's just started going retrograde. So now you will see that all the things which you are planning, which culminated after 16 June, will formalize in these 3 days, around these 3 days, okay, 9, 10, 11, 12 of April. You will see that, and till 22nd April, as I said, it will still be in Sagittarius, and then it will enter Jyeshtha Nakshatra again from Mula. So then what will happen is, from 10th to 12th or to 22nd, these 12 days, you will feel that now all the Gandanta effects, they have been neutralized now. I can clearly see the picture what is ahead. And from 22nd April, what will happen is, you will see that now I have to start running the race again. Or other saying, running the race again, you have to maintain what you have. See, because Jyeshtha is the nakshatra which is ruled by Indra. So Indra's position is, he is the, Indra is actually a post. Alright, he it's not the name of the person. So the current Indra's name is Purandar, that is mentioned in the Srimad Bhagavatam. So the system is like this, that there are a set of Manus. In one day of Brahma, there are 14 Manvantaras, as they say. Okay, and then every Manu has his own set of demigods, you know, like for example Indra, Chandra, Varuna, Agni, and all these demigods. So the Manvantar which is now currently is ruled by the person called Purandar, and the next Manvantara, the Indra, again the person who will be Indra, is actually Bali Maharaj. That is what Vamandev says in the Srimad Bhagavatam. It is clearly mentioned. But the essence of the post of Indra is, it is a post which everybody aspires to get. So you might have felt that the houses which Jupiter rules in your chart, regarding those houses, you would have felt that people were asking you that when will this house start functioning? When will this start happening? So for example, if suppose Jupiter is your fourth lord, maybe people were asking you all the time, sir, when will you purchase property? Sir, when will you purchase a home? Sir, when will you purchase a car? Yes, Saturn is seventh. Suppose Jupiter is your seventh lord, which means you are a Gemini Lagna, for example, or a Virgo Lagna. Then you might have felt that people were asking you again and again and again, when are you going to get married? Are you getting married? Or yes or no? These kind of things you would have felt. Or if you are married, then it can be something to do with your existing marriage, which people could be asking. So these are the things which, see, because Jyeshtha represents those things which people are always talking, or rather I would say gossiping. Alright, so that's what happens when planets transit Jyeshtha. People, the outer society becomes very concerned about those areas of your life, not their life, about your life, okay? And their friends and relatives and colleagues will be concerned about their particular area. So you would have definitely felt this. And now, after Jupiter's entry into the Gandanta zone, you would have felt that there are some answers to those questions regarding the houses which Jupiter rules. But now, as I said, you have to maintain, because Srimad Bhagavatam clearly says that Indra has a lot of anxiety maintaining the position at the top. So he's like the CEO of the universal affairs, you know, in a way that he manages all the things which are there under the direction of Lord Brahma, of course, and who is ultimately under the direction of Lord Vishnu. So now you will see this authority dynamics coming into picture. So you will feel that now you have to listen to some authority, what they say, and you have to exactly do what they want you to do. And Indra's story is there, you know, I will not go into the nakshatra, it will take time, but in that story he does something wrong, and later on he is punished because of that. Okay, so now till November of 2019, Jupiter will be in Jyeshtha Nakshatra throughout. So you need to know that if you do something wrong during this time, you will be punished severely. So refrain from doing any wrong activity during this time, okay? Especially related to the houses which Jupiter rules. So suppose Jupiter is your seventh lord, and it's related to your marriage, for example, then do not try to cheat on your spouse. I mean, you should never try to do that, but if you do it now, then you will be ruined. Your entire reputation will be ruined. That's what happened with Indra. His entire reputation was ruined. All right. anything it can be. So if Jupiter is your 10th lord, then do not do wrong things with your boss or with your colleagues or, you know, anybody in the authority zone, 9th house, then father or your gurus. So that's the point which I'm trying to make. Now is the time that you have to maintain what you already thought you got. Alright, so the game is over, but the game is not complete. Game is over means, yes, what you wanted you achieved, but you still need to consolidate it. Alright, and that's what happens. If you read the Srimad Bhagavatam, you'll see that Indra wins the fight with Vritrasura, but then there's a lot of things which he has to do later on. So basically till August 10th around, when Jupiter is continuing retrogression, you will see that this time, these 4 months, you know, April, May, June, July, you know, till beginning of August, these 4 months will go in consolidation of your victory or defeat. And then from August to November, you will see that that is the time when you finally understand what your limitations are, what your shortcomings are, what your strengths are, and which are the areas you are good at and which are the areas you are not good at. Alright, so that video I will do later. Jupiter's direct motion in Sagittarius, in Scorpio, of course. But now the rule of thumb is, you got something recently and now you must maintain that, whatever you have, okay? And do not think that the game is over. It's not over, even if it seems it is, alright? So, there you go. If you are new to the channel, then please like, comment, share and subscribe. Hit the thumbs up. And if you want a consultation from me regarding this transit, then you can go to my website to book a reading. You will find the link to the website down in the description section. And yes, God is there with you all the time. Just look to Him and you will find Him. Thank you very much. Good luck.